Hello everyone, we're back again. There's a one spot I did not explore yet that's around here. And I wanted to go find it. I guess it's down here. All right. If I die, I would say I'm saved, right? Nope, didn't die. Wait, where is it then? Is it up more? I'm gonna go see if I can find how to get up there. Check the local map, actually. Ah, here we go. Sorry there. Whoa. Bonesaw. Broken laser rifle. Aha! Oh, I need 100 lockpick? What's my lockpick? 82. I do have a locksmith's radar, good. Custom pistol case. Okay, there you go. The Wildcat 45. Huh. Man, I gotta find out where these cool energy weapons were. Cause there's a bunch of wow, there's a bunch of fission batteries. I think yeah, let's go make Sierra Madre slugs. Alright, that works. Let's check out this mad boy. The Wildcat. Here it is. Aha, here it is. Repaired. Earth things are always in shitty repair. Yeah. The 44 Magnum. Yeah, just repair the rest with the weapon repair kits. Gonna have an abundance of those motherfuckers. Oh, I need to mod this. Thompson compensator. Oh, I need the small handgun scope. Ooh, looks like a normal 45. Red sights though. But, eh. Doesn't look too bad. Oh, the survivalist is combat armor. I totally forgot about this. I totally forgot he had this. This is here. Yeah, this is actually pretty badass armor. Looks like Ranger combat armor because, well, Ranger combat armor is actually repurposed riot gear. So that's actually pretty fucking awesome. It's really worn. But let's see what the stats are on it. It's medium armor, sadly. I'm gonna drop 20 pounds. Ugh. And I'll do it. Repair the storm drums. I Yeah, probably could drop one of these, some of these fission batteries. Yep, there we go, that helped. A little. Let's see here, what else can I drop? Drop this carp. Drop that. Don't need these binoculars. Yeah, I don't really need this 50 cal. I really don't. So, I'm gonna drop it. It'll be here when I come back for it. Pretty sure. Yep, so, that'll work. Actually, why don't I drop the hunting rifle? Pick up back up my fucking gun. Where's my 50 cal? There it is. Worth it. Alright, let's see what's on this computer here. We'll be on our way. Oh, this must have been. Yeah, this must have been where he was. There's actually a thing where he mentions that he found a place where scientists were doing stuff. Though maybe this is the cave he's talking about. Storm tripwire. Oh wow, that one was in the ground. Come on. Oh shit. Holy shit. A bunch of bodies in here. Holy crap. Anything in here that's cool? That exits out. I guess that's the unsafe way to get out. Do do do. Okay, I dodged that bullet. Looks like there are experiments over here or something. Oh, it's a test. Where the hell did you get a gun? Oh, I must have picked up one of the storm drums or something. That works. No, they're distilling shit! Well, he was distilling shit, it seems. Leads back to the main room. Let's see what this man and guy is doing. Let's see if I can't make some packs. Still, this armor looks pretty badass. Ain't too bad it's medium, but still, it's caught. Sleep on the bedroll. Sits on the terminal here. Year two. Oh, 21. Fuckers killed all the men. I think they would have taken the women alive, but Maria and Selena opened fire, and some of the others went for their guns, so they shot them down and some of the kids with them. If I could have warned them. Only Carmen and five children still alive, being kept in a pen. There are more than 100 of these assholes in blue suits. Every suit says 22 on the back. Why? Why? Armed to the teeth with submachine guns, missiles, that's been 60% male. Everyone seems to follow the dark-haired guy, but can't get close enough to tell. Assholes are disciplined. Patrol, sentries, they mean business. Say I go in at night, get the women and children out, where to next? But I have to get them out. Have to. February 13th. Recon during the night. well organized. Sentry's most among most approaches, but stream not covered. Are they sick? Lots of coughing fits. Tuberculosis? Women and children still in pen. We'll try to infiltrate by stream tomorrow night. They ate them. Ambush along Riverside Trail. Six males killed. Heard they are coughing a mile away. Used their grenades to booby trap bodies. Kept half. Secured six SMGs, 500 rounds for 10mm, six frags. Ambush along Riverside Trail. Two males died. Checking bodies. Two more with rifle. Shot one through calf and let the asshole crawl off to spread a message. Cough like I'd shot through the lungs. Ambush half mile east of Coal Wash. Eight males killed. So we found some vault dwellers. Ambush in a narrow, six males killed. Took a 10mm through thigh. Steel jacket. Missed femoral. Lucky. Used tourniquet to make sure no blood splatter on rocks. Back to cave. Half set traps along entrance. All along entrance passage, but if they find me, it will be a matter of time. Still 24 confirmed kills in 10 days. Well, at least on third of their combat force. Not bad for an old man. March 2nd. Lucky, 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 lucky. Patrol small. Three men screaming woke me. Point man caught under a deadfall. Panic fire ricocheted into the cave. Almost hit me. Crawled forward and killed them all with the SMGs. Nearly used frags. Stupid. Finger and pin when remembered ricochets. Leaving at once. No other patrols in area, but they'll still be searching narrows for these three. Taking as much food as I can, drag with me, and head to cave south. So this is the first one, it seems. Broken laser rifle. Pretty cool. Get some gecko steak here. Alright. So that was worth getting it going in, huh? So, let's go and finish up this DLC. Actually, let me check, see where I haven't gone yet. There's here. That's actually, yeah, that's where I was just standing, isn't it? Or do I have to go out the other entrance to get the quick bite? Oh, okay. Well, I've been there, so I'll remember that. Or at least try to. And then fail at trying to remember it. And did it poorly. Okay, so. Hey, dead horse. Okay. Now let's fast travel down to Whitebeard's Cave, where we're supposed to be. Go and tell Daniel, I think, that we finished up what he wanted. Fish. There's Andrew down here. Fuck it. Pick this up. Free stim packs or free stim packs? Well, when I get syringes, but hey. Daniel, wake the fuck up. I need some medical assistance, can you help? Any medical supplies? I'm trading pre-war goods and supplies from the Mojave Wasteland. You need those too, don't you?
I do. Alright, I can provide you with supplies, but please rule.
Sure. Sweet. Stim pack. I'll take your cases of 45 ammo. Alright. Well, you don't have the best. I checked on everything in the valley and got you the map of this grand scave case.
Well, that's it. This is all we need. Now all that's left is to quietly pack up and try to get out of here. That's assuming that Joshua won't try to stop me.
Now, going back, whether you decide whether the star should fight or flee, your decision will set their destiny irrevocably in motion. You will be unable to finish any remaining quests in Zion once you make your decision, so choose wisely. Okay. That should level me. Yep, I will. Don't worry, I think leaving Zion is for the best. Wait, Gladys returns to Sarah camps. Yeah. All right. Let's get some energy weapons. That's a 75, because I need that up there. Start getting. What's my science at? How's my science higher than my fucking lockpick? All right. Let's get what I get this level. Nothing good. I'm going to get. Ch-ch-ch. I think I want to get Fight the Power, because that would actually be pretty useful. Because that works against Legion, Nairs, and. You know. Those guys are going to be ambushing me, like, everywhere. And I'm done. And this is the finale to the DLC. Let's go. Joshua Graham is giving you the Way of the Canaanite perk. While Joshua Graham is in your party, any Colt M1911 pistol you use has less spread and is twice as likely to score critical hits. And I'm over encumbered. By 6 pounds? What the hell did she give me? Jeez. Fuck this brush gun. I think it's worth a lot, but still, I'm not gonna sell it probably. I think I have stuff on me that I can drop. Drop them. Drop gecko hides. Drop that. Wow, those gecko eggs are 4 pounds each. Holy fuck. Okay, let's go. Wonder, does this count? Because this is, I think this is kind of, I hope this is counted as a, wait, let's see if it's under my effects. Yep, nope. Let us go! There's a couple things you need to know about, Joshua as a companion. He is not like a normal companion. He cannot carry your crap. He will not switch weapons for you. He basically anything on his companion wheel does not work, and he will not talk to you. So during the sequence, also he will not change weapons, but he uses a special gun called a Light Shining in the Darkness. A Light Shining in the Darkness is a smaller pistol, but it has a shit ton of power. Oh, and that, guess what his melee weapons is that he fucking pistol whips people. Oh God, don't. I'm about to just pull out my fucking. Where is it? Weapon. Wait. Right. You are going to there. You are going to there. You're going to there. Never mind. He's on it. Yeah, so basically, what's happening right now is it's called We're Going on a Kick-Ass Tour. Kick-Ass Tour! Yeah. Johnny Bravo's now in my head. Awesome. Come on. Come on, you motherfucker, where are you? Haha, I found. Oh wow, Rebirth Club. Never mind! Why do you have 50 caliber rounds if you don't have a 50 caliber gun? Whatever. Wait, is there more areas that unlock after you? No, I just saw Sentinels is over here. Let's go finish this up. Huh? Four or five ammo. Somebody decided it was a good idea to sell my shit and to drop, cases in there. Let's do it. Sliding down like a badass. And while this is going on, your fast travel is disabled. Just so you know. So if even if you found the Pine Creek Tunnel, you cannot fast travel there. So you gotta walk your ass over there. Which I thought was cool. It's good for effect, because you gotta go through and fight everybody. Am I gonna be able to get through here this way? No. I don't think I am. So. I think Josh was kicking ass. Dang it, Josh was always kicking ass. It's kind of assumed, because Josh was like, in my opinion, Joshua Graham is like the Chuck Norris of it. I mean, even though he used to be Legion. Oh, there's an optional quest I have? Prisoners of War. Ah. And there's a bunch of optional quests I guess you can do, huh? Oh, they're all the way over there. Fuck it. Hell. I'll meet you over there. Alright, we're almost there. We're making our approach. You think this. For some reason, I think this DLC is bigger than it actually is. Like the area. Not very big. It's, it's nowhere near Mojave big. But, it's decent size, but. Yeah, don't think that it's gonna take forever to get this place. So that's what I was thinking, but not. Okay, that's Morning Glory Cave, I think. So we're going to go free some prisoners. Yeah. I didn't know there's optional quests. Oh, look at that moon. It's all red and shit. It's like Mars and something. So yeah, how the hell are we gonna get up here? There's a trail. Yeah, there's a trail that we can follow. Arch. Man, I really like how this gun looks. And it doesn't look too much different, but I want to see how. I think it has a different amp. It has a scope, so. Whoa! What? Oh, come on! Seriously? I didn't see my ammo. Least somebody had that other quest done. Alright, I'll I'll meet you back there. Okay, this is approach try number two. Hopefully this time we won't fail horribly by dying. Thought I had the shotgun. A riot shotgun equipped to that slot. What the hell? There we go. That's better. That is, holy shit, that's actually, I said that. Fuck it, we're going in. Bam. How wide the unlock it? You're free to go. Jeez. Anything new up here? Nah. Pork beans. Get some of them pork beans, you know, huh? Alright, I'll meet you at the next quest. Okay, we're almost there. This time we're retaking a bridge. So. Joshua Graham kicking that ass. Look at that. That's yeah. Everybody says something different if you point your gun at them. It's stupid, but no. See what they got. Boom. Bitch. Oh shit. Of course I miss. Take it. Can I get up there? Oh, wait. Oh, come on. There we go. I can search you from here. Yeah. Take a nade. Don't really give a shit about your SMG. See that Lightbringer head? For some reason, whenever I saw the Lightbringer, I always thought they had laser weapons. No, they just have the. F they have. I think they have. They just have normal guns, but they have the automatics. Alright. How close are we? Ooh, just over this ridge. See if I can get this motherfucker in the head. Just sneak attack critical. That was an actual real gun. My sniper rifle. I'm gonna switch out to my sniper. Let's see here. Weapons. Where are you? Dropping down there because I die. Should be way down safely. Oh shit, I'm stuck, aren't I? Shit. Who needs achievements, right? Yeah, I finally get my achievements to work. Can't get the achievement because guess what? I got stuck. Okay then. So the only quest left. Flight from Zion. How am I gonna get down? Because I have to go down the way over there. Actually, I think this is a safe enough drop if I land on the thing. Yeah, okay. There we go. What a pun. Now, let's see what awaits us at the end. And this sniper rifle is big. I was like, I've been playing sniper in TF2, right? And I was like, oh man. Thinking the sniper rifle in TF2 is big. I just realized it's just as big on my screen as a sniper rifle is. It's just yes, it does the math. Oh fuck. You take these motherfuckers from me. Oh, I got him! I critical strike on Cross to Graham. Fuck. I didn't want to do that. Oh well, let's switch back to. I'll switch back from my hotkeys. Where's that gecko steak I've been eating? Ah, there it is. Let's sit here and regen my health. Okay, it's more gecko steak. Yes, I will take your case for your 50 cal though. 12 gauge. Yeah, rather chuck. I can repair it with that. That should be enough for end here. This guy was like, "Oh, I'm grabbing this gun." Grabs the gun off the motherfucker, off this guy, off that guy, and just starts beating ass. It's like that horse in Seamus's. Oh, it's saving. Deals. Fight your way to the Pine Creek Tunnel. Deals salt upon wounds. Wait, there's no reason this had to, has to end in bloodshed. Your power is broken. You cannot hope to prevail here. Leave this valley in peace. Let's go.
You've done more than I could have ever hoped. Thank you. And may God protect you for all of your days.
Detonator added. Joshua Graham has left your company. You have lost Joshua Graham's Wave of the Canaanite perk. Daniel's given you such. Firing the winter collapse passage to prevent any wet legs from falling down on the solids out of Zion. Can't do anything else. Boom, another level. So, that is the end of Dawnest Hearts. And we level up! Yay! So let's get my lock pick up to 95. That'll 96. Will that work? Get my sciences, my guns up to stage 2. Okay, where do we go? 28. Reabsorption. Oh, that's actually a pretty useful perk. Travel light. Yeah, I need 4 or 5. I'll get that next level. Red absorption, yay! Very useful perk. What's this? A footlocker. Well, this is where we entered Zion in from. What's this footlocker here? Let's see what's in here. A light shining in the darkness. Very cool. Chalk's headdress. Daniel's hat. Daniel's outfit. Joshua Graham's armor. Salt Moon's helmet. Salt Moon's power fist with an HP debuff. And scripture. Crap. What are we gonna drop for that? I could always drop this. No, that's not gonna get me. That's only gonna get me a 78. Fuck. Drop the kitchen knife. But yeah, that's Honest Hearts. And I'm Honest not playing Counter-Strike. Thank you for popping up in my Let's Play. So what we find out is that I think with the whole theme of this DLC is that there never really is a right answer to a situation. Because everyone, even if something good happened for their tribe or whatever, it never seemed like it was exactly the right choice. You never found out if everybody always doubted. Oh, by the way, Joshua Graham's armor, 15 DT, plus 3 crit chance. That it looks pretty badass. I'll show you. Yeah. Then Salt Palm Wounds is Power Fist, pretty big. But yeah, that's. That's how it is. I mean, you never know if you made the right decision, and you can only hope that it would be. So I'm gonna drop this hunting rifle because I don't need that now. I'm trying to get out all the guns that I think would be useful on the way home. Light shining in darkness. Actually, I'll drop this and show you if I can. I drop it. If you look at his light shining in darkness, there is actually stuff written on the side of it in Greek, which is the actual scripture passage it references. I think it says on the side there. Yeah, if you look on there, yeah, there's no iron. It's only iron sights on this thing, but there's actually a cool thing I'll show you if I can get to go to night. Which I've only read about this. I didn't notice it before. But it seems to kind of glow. If I can get. Right. 6 p.m. Let's actually try and get it to be darker. See, the sights kind of glow there. So, fits with it. I'm gonna have to drop. What am I gonna drop? Crap. This large burned book, that. Quest inventory. You can't remove quest items from your inventory. Blah! Why do I have a butter knife on me? Oh, this substance C, you'll find out that, what that's for. That's actually for World Pain. The scripture does nothing, but it's basically a little prop that Daniels has on him. You can sell that? See if I can drop anything that's heavy enough. 8 pounds. That's how heavy that armor is. Daniel's outfit gives you 5 medicine, 5 barter. That's pretty cool. Sneak plus 5. That looks absolutely ridiculous, but eh. I don't know how that helps you, like, you know. Wow, 6,000 caps, 3,000 caps. I don't want to drop anything too valuable. I really don't. Yeah, this SMG. Yeah, let's drop that. There we go. And now we go back. And I think no, we're not gonna level up again. I don't think. And we make it back to the Mojave Wasteland. So, I'll see y'all next time, guys. Finale J out. And then, I think it's time for some science!